In our search and understanding to biblical accounts from the before time, we ponder if the Tower of Babel was exaggerated. The Great Tower was said to represent a global united civilization that was divided and scattered across the earth by a great cataclysmic event. It is said the tower was built by this civilization in an attempt to reach heaven, but destroyed by the beings in which they were attempting to reach. We have searched the earth for where this event took place with some notable candidates, in particular Itaminaki, which is dedicated to Marduk, is one of the best candidates for such a site. Wait to hear this. In its day, Itaminaki, or the Ziggurat of Babylon, as it is commonly known, would have rivaled that of the Great Pyramid of Giza in size and scale. When the Great Tower was first built is unknown, but we can theorize it to have been before the Great Flood, and rebuilt in the 6th century BC on a much lesser scale. The authors of Genesis 11, 1 through 9 were inspired by the existence of an apparently incomplete ziggurat at Babylon, and by the phonetical similarity between Babylonian Bab-Alu, meaning gate of God, and the Hebrew word Balal, meaning mixed, confused, or confounded. And they began to build, and in the fourth week they made brick with fire, and the bricks served them for stone, and the clay with which they cemented them together was asphalt, which comes out of the sea, and out of the foundations of water in the land of Shinar. And they built it. 43 years were they building it. Its breadth was 203 bricks, and the height of a brick was the third of one. Its height amounted to 543 cubits and 2 palms. The reference to a ziggurat at Babylon in the creation epic Enuma Elish is more solid evidence, however, for a Middle Assyrian piece of this poem survives to prove the long-held theory that it existed already in the 2nd millennium BC. There is no reason to doubt that this ziggurat, described as Ziggurat Apsi Elite, the upper ziggurat of the Apsu, was Itaminaki. The city of Babylon had been destroyed in 689, and the structure was also lost. It took 88 years to rebuild the city. Its central feature was the Temple of Marduk, in which the Itaminaki ziggurat was associated. The ziggurat was rebuilt by Nebuchadnezzar II. The 7 stories of the ziggurat reached a height of 91 meters, according to a tablet from Uruk, and contained a temple shrine at the top. The Babylonians didn't see their Tower of Babel as a failure. As far as they were concerned, they really had made a stairway that they could walk up to go see the gods. The tower was built on a spot that the Babylonians believed was the exact center of the universe. It was here, they believed, that their God created the world. Here alone, heaven and earth could interconnect, as long as someone could just build a staircase that went up high enough. The truth must be that by the time of Alexander, the ziggurat had fallen into disrepair. Buildings made of brick easily fall apart and need permanent care in the hot climate of the Near East. Alexander ordered 10,000 soldiers to remove the remains of the building. Over a period of 2 months, tiles and bricks were brought to the eastern part of the city. This time, the tower was not destroyed by any army looking for loot. It was a systematic attempt to clear the building ground. Babylon was never restored to its old status, and that meant the end of the attempt to rebuild the ancient site. Although one scribe in Uruk was still hoping for its reconstruction and wrote the Louvre tablet. The Esagila remained intact well into the 1st century BC, and probably even later. Arabic authors were responsible for keeping the memory of the tower alive, sometimes comparing the greatest of the ancient city with the humble town Babel of their own age. However, they thought that the ancient royal palace, which was the largest ruin on the site, was the Tower of Babel. The inhabitants of Babel told the same to the first Western visitors in the 16th century. In the 19th century, the real Itaminaki was rediscovered by the native Arab population. People of the nearby village wanted to create a palm garden and discovered ancient bricks when they lowered the groundwater level. German engineers understood the significance, and in 1913, Robert Coldway started the excavation of the Itaminaki. Today, only four channels can be seen. The rest of the site is overgrown with weed, though using modern satellite imagery, we can peer down onto a part of ancient history, which is still the subject of much debate as to if it ever even existed. Genesis being widely regarded as mythology and never acknowledged as records with any sort of accuracy outside of religious circles. But you must consider what these stories are based on in the first place. Not everyone can be wrong, can they? What do you guys think of this anyway? Is this actually the site of the Tower of Babel? Comments below, and thank you for watching.